sure you're in there. We have a private chat, a Zoom chat group. It's on all the time. We can answer questions. And I usually post the recordings and special events and mind maps that I just made up here. So make sure you're on there if you're not already. What are the behaviors of successful people? They're reasonable risk takers. What does that mean? Reasonable is the operative word, isn't it? Somebody just wanted to come on here. There they are. What does it mean to be reasonable? A reasonable risk taker.
They take calculated risks.
Okay. When we take a risk, what should be part of our analysis when we take a risk? What should we do before we take that risk?
Do our homework.
Yeah. Due diligence. Ask tough questions. What does it say on the Missouri license plate? What does it say on, someone's got some background noise here. What does it say on that Missouri license plate?
Is that show me state?
Show me. People say all these things. Show me. You tell me I'm going to get an 18% return. Show me how you've done that in the past. Okay. We can take reasonable risks. That's a cactus behind my house in California. We take total responsibilities. What happens when we make mistakes, and what does a loser do? What does the loser
do? People.
Blames others.
Blames others. Blames God. Blames the politicians. Blames the weather. Blames lawyers. Lawyers are okay. Okay. See, we kill our own. Okay. So they take total risk. I'm serious about this. You say, you know, there's something about when you make a mistake, you say, you know what? That was my bad. I'm apologize. I'm sorry. I did something wrong. I'm a fallible human being. And can we start over again? Can we fix this? Can we learn from our mistakes? You better believe it.
Definitely.
Absolutely. Create an environment of success. Why do we need, what's an environment of success?
Have other successful people around us.
Yes.
To learn from.
Thank you. What happens when we hang around negative people? What happens when we watch the news too much? I've been watching this a lot lately. Huh? What happens when we're watching all that negative news all the time?
Yeah.
You get pulled down and gloomy.
Yeah. What happens? And back to motivation. What happens when we hear successful? And that's one of the things I like on when we get together here. I like to hear success stories. We've been talking a lot about successful deals and how other people are making money and how they're running their business and things like that. We want to be around positive people. We want to be around successful people. My mentor used to always say, success and failure leave clues. What's a successful person? How does a successful person act?
Happy.
Enthusiastic.
Enthusiastic, happy. Absolutely. How about, and a lot of times I do other things, exercise. I play music all the time in my office. Okay. Sometimes, just create that environment of success. Can you have fun in your business? Should you have fun in your business?
Sure.
Definitely. Yeah.
You've got to. If it's just a job, it's you're not going to have that long-term involvement in it. You're going to start procrastinating. Set timely goals. Timely, reasonable goals. By the way, I'm using, I use MindNode, MindNode. It's a wonderful mind map application. You can do it on your laptop, on your iPad, on your iPhone. Even your Apple Watch, you can look up your old, I have probably about 200 mind maps. Whenever I have a challenge or a new idea or something, I make up a mind map. I made up this mind map. I started yesterday in the car, and then I finished it early this morning. It's that easy to put together. It's called MindNode. So just, I don't own it or anything, but I believe in throwing things on paper to immortalize them, to keep them around. Set reasonable goals. What's a reasonable goal? What do we talk about every week? The rule of five? Is that a reasonable goal to speak to five people a day? That's the behavior of successful people, setting reasonable daily goals. Can you be an independent thinker? Is it hard? Is it hard here in almost 2023 to be an independent thinker when we have this group mentality so often?
No.
Who's an independent thinker here? Who can think, who cannot get caught up emotionally sometimes and not? Ricky, add your hand up. What do you mean? Unmute yourself there. Let me hear your thoughts.
You asked if who's an independent thinker?
Yeah.
In regards to like just making decisions or
being successful. Don't you love people who think out of the box, who think a little differently? Are you an independent? Do you go with the crowd all the time? Or do you say, no, that's just wrong. I won't do that. I'm not going to give my life savings to an unknown cryptocurrency. I'm not going to jump on this bandwagon here because everybody else is doing it.
I feel like I'm that type of guy. I feel like I try, for some reason, if everybody's doing it, I kind of just, you know, want to be different.
Isn't it hard though to stand out from the crowd sometimes?
Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely. But thank you for that. Be an independent thinker. Do you think Elon Musk, do you think he sees, I always talk about Elon. I think a guy who can invent rocket ships to Mars and land them on the base instead of the water, who can build tunnels under cities, who can make electric cars when people said they don't work anymore. Do you think he thinks a little bit differently? How about Steve Jobs? Who else is an independent thinker? People who think differently in our society and are rewarded for it too.
Yes.
How about, let's go to the next.
Jeff Bezos. Yeah.
There we go. How did Jeff Bezos get started?
In his garage.
Yeah.
Selling books.
He sold books.
Yes. He
started selling books online.
Yes.
Barnes & Noble and everybody else out there, nobody thought about just selling books online.
Yeah. Uncle Claude.
Yes.
He's independent thinker.
I try to be.
You are.
I try to be. I try to analyze things and I say, is this really true? Is this is this something I really believe in? Is this person emotional or rational? You know, we talk about the $1 million rule all the time, Helen. Here, I think we have someone else who joined, Alan Knowles. There he goes. Okay, let's get him. How about, let's go to the next one here because time is going fast. Somebody mentioned it early. Are we always learning? School is never over. Does anybody have a monopoly on all the knowledge in the world?
No.
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 No. No.
Yeah. I read every day. By the way, you spoke about Jeff Bezos before. I love Audible and Kindle. I love that stuff. When I'm exercising or when I have free time, I open a book or listen to a book. I try to read. Somebody's got some strong background noise. Sorry, could you mute yourself, please? Thank you. We still have some noise. Somebody else, please mute yourself.
Okay.
Where is that? I think that's Rick. Okay. Rick, shame on you. You're giving us so much background noise. Let's go back to the mind map. I read the New York Times, the Wall Street Journal. I read a really good, my favorite news magazine is The Week. It's a collection of articles from all over the world every week. You got to stay on top if you want to be successful. These are the behaviors of successful people. Be positive, be enthusiastic, be happy. Do things you enjoy. We talked about that a little. What are other behaviors of successful people? They have guts. They may do things, they may pick up the phone and talk to strangers. Okay, how scary is it to pick up the phone and talk to people in a positive way sometimes and have control of the conversation? It's hard, isn't it?
It can be daunting.
It can be tough. Are people always nice to us on the phone?
No.
Has anyone had the the snippy. Why do people, and we talk about this all the time, that's why I don't like scripts. Okay, because if we sound like everyone else, are we going, can we anticipate that we're going to get the same 95 to 99% rejection because we sound the same and the prospect knows what we're there for?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So we get this, but the prospect is not a bad person. They're just tired of being inundated by so much marketing. Are we just knocked out by marketing all day long? Have you guys gone to the supermarket or Walmart? They have TV screens in the aisles now. Okay. It's like so much noise. And then they're playing some really bad Christmas music in the background with the TV screens and everything else going on. You know, so we have to sound different. We have to use, and we're not going to discuss it today, those pattern interrupts. Opening up a conversation in a different way.
400.
I'm sorry. Who's ever talking? Please mute yourself. Thank you. Okay. I got to find out who's making the background noise again. Alex Julian. Shame on you, Alex. Got to just work that mute button there. Otherwise, all of us can hear what you're saying and doing. Let's go back to there. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Focus on the focus. How many people are like me? I'm like a two-week-old puppy with a new toy. How many people here are easily distracted? Okay. I'm very honest about my behavior.
That would be me, yeah.
Okay.
That would be me.
Does anyone here ever have where you're in a quiet place? And you're intensely focused on a book, on a movie, on a project, and you're amazed at how much you get done when you have that intense focus. Okay, and sometimes I think we're in a busy, noisy world, aren't we? How many people think that we need a quiet space once in a while, don't we?
Yeah, I've got a remark on that too. Everybody says they're multitasking, which means you're doing several things badly instead of doing one thing well and getting it done. Just, you know, if you focus on something, you get it done. If you're scattered, multitasking, nothing gets done.
I kind of agree with that.
Yeah, I'll enjoy. I think, let me just to put this out. I like to go running every day. I like to exercise every day. And while I'm running or walking or jogging or whatever, I like to listen to an audiobook or music. Is that multitasking?
Yes, in a good way.
So, thank you for saying that, Jessica. So can multitasking also, it's got a big negative, and I think Randy was right, but can it also be a positive if we're using physical with mental together?
Yes.
I think as long as you're only focusing on one thing, it's fine. You know, yeah. Like you don't need to think about running. You just do it. So you're listening as you go.
Thank you, Billy. I'm shocked that every now and then I'll try to get to a real quiet place. I'll shut off the phones. I will focus intensely on a project. I did this outline for today's discussion in the car yesterday. Claudia was driving and it was just really quiet. I had my, best advice for helping you focus is these little earbuds here. And you can set them. They're wonderful on a plane with screaming children, by the way. Okay. You can set them to silence. Okay. And they really dampen about 75, 80% of the outside noise. These are really wonderful if you travel. Okay. Sometimes our planes can be really noisy, even the drone of the engines. You put these in your ears and it's quiet. It's much quieter. It's so valuable to create your own little. Remember who remembers a TV show called Get Smart? Okay, it was a comedy show by Mel Brooks, and he was always going into the cone of silence. Okay, am I the only one who watched that show?
I remember it.
There you go. So focus.
On Agent 99.
Yes, Mel Brooks, and if you've never seen Young Frankenstein or Blazing Saddles or The Producers, The guy is, he's very politically unwoke, uncorrect, but he's very funny. Absolutely. How about confidence? Do we have to have confidence? Very high confidence. We talked about this earlier. I want your input on this. I think the only way you can have unbridled high confidence is to have actual success, not short-term, short-term events or writing your affirmations down. What do we all do at New Year's? What do they tell us to do every New Year's?
Write down your affirmation.
Year's resolution.
Yeah, okay. Is that really, I mean, that might heighten your awareness to take that moment to write things down. But is that something, I mean, how many people write down they're going to lose 10 pounds? Okay, on their New Year resolution.
Done it.
Okay, but how do you really lose 10 pounds?
Get out and jog it off.
Yeah, yeah. You got to put down the Twinkies, right?
Yes.
We're not going to go there. Confidence, in my opinion, is only something you can have if you've achieved success. Anything else, positive affirmations, walking on hot coals or whatever, are temporary. There's nothing wrong with a motivational speaker. Somebody who makes you feel good, a great speaker, Anthony Robbins or Les Brown or somebody like that. But how do you truly internalize confidence? I want to hear from you guys. How do you internalize confidence so you feel so good about yourself? Does that manifest itself on the phone when you speak to someone in a confident tone? Is that important when you're negotiating?
I do it by not limiting myself.
And when we're in a world where there's negativity, where there's a lot of, I think rejection in sales, in real estate, is the death of success. And the only way we get, and if you're pounded down and rejected, and people say, take me off your list, you're the 10th person to call me, and you hear that all day long, what does that do to your confidence? Yeah. When you hear somebody who's enthusiastic, who's joyful, how does that manifest it? Does that kind of, is it contagious to the prospect, the person you're trying to do business with? I think so. I like to talk to people who enjoy what they're doing for a living. Whoever it is. How about strong communication skills? What do we talk about every week here? Sales, verbal sales skills. How to ask questions. How important is it? I think it's the most important. I think you need three things to succeed. You need strategies. Especially if you're in real estate or whatever product or service, you need marketing. So you have quality prospects, people to talk to every day with a follow-up system. But the most important is, how do you sound on the phone to people? Do you have a system where you know how to ask questions, get the information, get them emotionally involved? How important are strong communication skills in your success? I've met people smarter than me. Go ahead. Somebody else was speaking.
Yeah, I was just going to say that, you know, you also don't have to know everything, right? Like for me, I always feel like I've got to know everything, every situation to be able to, that the investor might, that the tenant buyer, let's say, or seller might be asking me, but I don't have to know that. I just have to be able to go to the next step, and then I can figure that stuff out, you know, later.
Yes.
Which mm-hmm. is kind of like what you talk about, you know, through the gut steps.
Mm-hmm. What are the three most important words in sales?
I don't know.
Ask me a question. Anything. Why is the sky blue? Anything.
Yeah.
What am I having for dinner?
Yeah. What's the last step in the lease purchase?
That's a good question. I'm not sure if I know what you mean. I don't know. Why you must have asked that for a reason. Help me out, Wade. Why is that important to you?
Yeah, I just want to know, you know,
here it comes.
How we're gonna, finish up this transaction, basically.
Oh, okay. So if we found a way to finish up the transaction, there's not a time constraint here, right? Or is there?
No, there isn't.
Okay. Do you want it sooner, before the holidays, after the holidays, by Groundhog's Day next year? I mean, what's your time frame?
Yeah, after the holidays would be good.
Okay. So could we do a contract today and subject to after New Year's? And so we could facilitate an agreement today. You wouldn't be open to that, would you?
No, I could do that.
What?
Yes, I could do that.
Okay. That whole conversation came from what question that Wade started with? Who remembers?
What's the last step in a lease purchase?
Yeah. What's the last step in a lease purchase? Sometimes saying not having all the answers. I think somebody said Bailey or somebody said it earlier. Not having always the answer. I think we think in our mind, oh, I've got to know every answer to every question. Sometimes not having the answer or feigning ignorance is the term in the gut sales method. Saying, gee, good question. Why did you ask that? I don't know. What did you mean by that? Could you reinterpret that? Or could you share with me why you brought up that question? What does that force you to, what does that force the prospect to do?
Think about their question again.
And what's the benefit to us?
Clarify for you.
More information, clarification, possibly emotional motivation. And can we go right? Was I closing you in that? I mean, I know it was just a fun role play, but was I going for the close based on you asking a question?
Yeah.
So rather than do free consulting, use those strong communication skills, okay, to have a sales system so you can close. Time is going too fast. Let's move on here a little bit. Consistent. Do we need to have consistent behavior?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. You want to be successful. What do successful people do? They get into a routine. Mm-hmm. I have a routine every day. Okay. I exercise every day. I check my emails at a certain time. I do study reading. I do the rule of five. I want to speak to at least 3 to 5 people a day. Follow up with 3 to 5 people. Do five social media plants in TikTok, in YouTube, in Instagram. Every day, that consistent behavior is what's going to make you very successful rather than stop and go. Mm-hmm. Be a little outspoken. Okay. You don't have to do what everybody else does. We tend to copy everybody else, but we should only copy people who are what?
Successful.
Successful. Thank you. Okay. Have an unwavering belief in yourself in spite of negativity from others. I had so many people who told me, gee, you can't do this. Nobody's ever done that. Do you ever hear that from people? Oh, gee, yes. Nobody does it like that way. Why are you doing it that way?
Mm-hmm.
Because your way doesn't work. And I think there's a better way to do things. So we don't have to get stuck in the mud. That's the Pikes Peak, by the way. I did a run at Pikes Peak. Yeah, it's 14,000 feet. You want to talk about thin air?
Oh, yeah.
And if you've ever been to Colorado, you got to go to Pikes Peak. You can drive up or you can be crazy like your Uncle Claude and run up. Okay. Charismatic. Have fun. My mentor was very naturally charismatic, naturally happy. People like people enthusiastic who are happy. And enjoy what they're doing. How important for success is doing something we enjoy?
Very.
Okay. I love this business. I look forward to it. I like working. I have a lot of friends who retired. They had jobs for 30, 40 more years. Okay. And they couldn't wait till they retired. Now they play golf all day. Nothing wrong with golf. Okay. But is that what it's all? How about if your work is not a four-letter word? You actually have fun doing what you're doing while you're doing it. How many people here see the negotiate, finding a deal, thinking of the right strategy, then